Now, this is ground. A body is dropped on the ground from a height h. After collision, it rebounds to a height h1. After second collision, it rebounds to a height h2. After third collision, it rebounds to a height h3, and so on. Okay, from the previous discussion, we know that coefficient of restitution E is equal root of h2 by h1. Here it is root of h2 by h1, that is h1 by h. Okay, now e square is equal h1 by h, that implies h1 is equal to e square h. This is the height attained by the body after first collision. Next, I find h2. In the second collision, E is equal to root of H2 by H1. Okay. That is, E square is equal to H2 by H1. That implies H2 is equal to E square H1. Is equal to E square. What is H1? E square H. So, H2 is equal to E power 4 H. In the third collision, E is equal to root of H3 by H2. So here I write E square is equal to H3 by H2. So, h3 is equal to e square h2, is equal to e square. What is h2? Here we got e power 4 h. Okay, so h3 is equal to e power 6 h. Similarly, h4 is equal to e power 8 h. Am I right? So, what is hn? Hn is equal to e power 2n into h. This is the height attained by the body after nth rebound. This is the height attained by the body after nth rebound. Keep this formula in your mind. Next, velocity after nth collision, that is to be determined now. Velocity after nth collision. Now this is the ground. A body is dropped on the ground. The body strikes the ground with a velocity v and rebounds with a velocity v1 after first collision. And then it falls down and hits the ground with the same velocity v1. Again it rebounds. in the second rebound its velocity is v2, then it falls down and hits the ground with the same velocity v2 and then rebounds. With a velocity v3 and so on. Okay. Now, in all collisions, what about ground? Its velocity is 0 before collision and after collision. Okay. For first collision, what is the initial velocity of the sphere? V. Okay. What is its velocity after collision? V1. Right. What about ground? Its velocity before collision is 0 and its velocity after collision is 0. We know E is equal to V2 minus V1 by U1 minus U2. So E is equal to 0 minus V1 by, what is U1 here? V minus 0. So, E is equal to minus V1 by V. Let minus V1 is equal to V1 because it is in opposite direction. So, here instead of minus V1, I substitute V1. Then E is equal V1 by V or V1 is equal EV. Okay. This is the velocity of the body in the first collision. In the second collision, for second collision, similarly we can write V2 is equal to EV1. Okay. That implies V2 is equal to E into what is V1? EV. So, V2 is equal to E square V. This is the velocity attained after second collision. What is the velocity attained after third collision? V3 is equal to EV2 is equal to E into what is V2? Here we got V2 is equal to E square V. E into E square V. So V3 is equal to E cube V and so on. What is Vn? E power n into V. This is the velocity of the body after nth collision. Okay. Here minus V1 is equal to V1 because after the rebound, the velocity will be in the opposite direction. Right. Now, total distance traveled by the body before it stops bouncing, that is to be determined. Total distance traveled by the body before it stops bouncing. This is the ground. A body is dropped from a height h, it rebounds to a height h1 after first collision, and then it rebounds to a height h2 after second collision, and so on. Now I am going to determine the total distance traveled by the body before it stops bouncing. Before it stops bouncing, s is equal, what is this distance h plus, then it goes up a distance h1 and it falls down the same distance. So what is this total distance 2h1, what is this 2h2, what is this 2h3, and so on. 2h1 plus 2h2 plus 2h3 and plus so on. Okay, is equal to h plus, what is 2h1? We know here hn is equal e power 2n into h. Okay, then what is h1? H1 is equal e square h, h2 is equal e power 4h, h3 is equal e power 6h, and so on. Here I substitute s is equal h plus 2, what is h1? E square h, plus 2 into what is h2? E power 4h, plus 2 into what is h3? E power 6h, plus so on. Okay, right. S is equal h into 1 plus 2e square plus 2e power 4 plus 2e power 6 plus so on. Next is equal h into 1 plus, here 2e square is taken as common, 2e square into 1 plus e square plus e power 4 plus so on, right? Now h into 1 plus 2e square into, what is this? This is a geometrical progression. What is first term? 1. What is common ratio? E square by 1, that is e square. Okay, sum of infinity terms. Here I write, s infinity is equal to a by 1 minus r, okay, where r is the common ratio, here it is less than 1, here r is less than 1, okay. So instead of a, I substitute 1 by 1 minus, instead of r, I substitute e square, right? Is equal to h into 1 plus 2e square by 1 minus e square, is equal to h into 1 minus e square plus 2e square by 1 minus e square, is equal to h into 1 plus e square by 1 minus e square. This is the total distance traveled by the body before it stops bouncing. Okay, here what is this progression? Geometrical progression. What is sum of infinity terms? S infinity is equal to a by 1 minus r, where what is a? First term, that is a is equal to 1. What is r? R is equal to common ratio is equal to second term by first term, e square by 1 is equal to e square. Okay, here I found applying this formula. Now this is the total distance traveled by the body before it stops bouncing.